Parents, do your kids have the Boo app? I'm going to talk to you about what this app is, how they had a huge security breach not that long ago, and then also what you can do to keep your kids safe and smart online. Now, first, Boo app marketing says Boo is your own 3D avatar. Customize your avatar with tons of face features, hairstyles, and outfits. Decorate your Boo home with a variety of stylish items. Have fun with friends by visiting each other's home, sending and receiving greetings, collaborating in camera, generating dual stickers, and making cool movies. Now, it's home, friends, create your avatar, greeting, items, and discover. Now, at the end of this, I want to give you the opportunity to join my live online parent night event. You know, I get to do this all over the country. And at the end of this, I want to tell you all this neat stuff that you'll learn from me April 23rd, 24th, or 25th. If you're a school, click one of the links below to learn how you can work with us to bring this to your community. I want to teach you everything you need to know to avoid the bad apps and get your kids to be safe and smart online. I think we have one of the best pieces of content in the country. Back to the Boo app. Now, the Boo app, formerly Boomoji, is a social network where users create an avatar that they use to chat with others, sometimes strangers. When users create an avatar, they can customize physical features, hairstyles, and outfits. Then users decorate their home in the app, which acts like a profile. Users can visit each other's homes in the app like a profile, and it encourages users to create a greeting using their avatar and their voice recording that welcomes users to their home. It gets a little scary when your kids are younger because strangers might be able to hear that greeting. Users can take selfies in the app and they're turned into an avatar. Now, similar to the Moji It app, and you can see that other app guide on smartsocial.com, users can place their avatar in real places with augmented reality videos. Now, if you're listening to our podcast or watching us on YouTube, please rate, subscribe, and review, or give us that thumbs up so that I can share my message with people all over the world and continue to keep kids safe. Users share videos or pictures in this app of their avatars with one another. Friends can pair up and take pictures of their avatars together. Now, users can select the avatar's expressions, poses, and backgrounds, and when users play the games on the Boo app, they earn points that can be used to buy clothes, decorations, and other features for their avatar. This is my personal opinion, and this is where it gets weird. It gets weird when they're gamifying it with points, and this is how these apps get you. They add points, they gamify it so you can redeem it for real products, or you can borrow your parents' credit card, and you can say, Mom or Dad, I want to buy $3 or $4 or $5. You spend real money oftentimes. Most of these apps want real money to buy points, to do things with their friends. They've gamified it so you're spending stuff. Scary. Users can also use real money to buy things for their avatar. Now, why should parents care? Well, at the time of this app guide, the Boo app is one of the 15 most popular social media free apps on the App Store, so it's easy and popular with students. The Boo app integrates with iMessage on iPhones, which helps contribute to its popularity. It's easy to use. We call that slippery. It's seamless. It's easy to download, to use, to have fun with. The Boo app was formerly called Boomoji, but it changed its name after it exposed the personal information of its 5 million users. This is where it gets scary, guys. If your student had the app before December of 2018, or if their friends did, it's likely that their phone number and any personal information they linked to the app was exposed. Now, I want to show you how to fix that when you join our Smart Social Parent community. But in our experience, when tweens and teens have anonymous avatars to hide behind, they tend to misbehave more than if their actions are tied to their real name. In fact, people behave in a way we've never seen possible when they are anonymous. One of the biggest key takeaways right now, do not let your kids use anonymous apps. They tend to go down a bad road. They have less friends, more anxiety, more depression. It goes down. Go to smartsocial.com to learn more. Apps like these don't help your children build a positive digital footprint, and they don't help your children build friendships. Now, here's what TechCrunch says. In December 2018, the Boo app had a massive data security breach or security issue. Popular animated avatar creator app Boomoji, with more than 5 million users across the world, exposed the personal data of its entire user base after it failed to put passwords on two of its internet-facing databases. Databases are the thing behind that store all of the interactions and stuff, and they didn't password protect it. Each record also included the user's unique Boomoji ID, which was linked to the other tables in the database. Those other tables included which school they go to sometimes, and a feature that Boomoji touts as a way for users to get in touch with other fellow students. This is where it's scary for your students to put information on apps that we don't really know much about because we don't know how secure they are. Now, I want to talk to you about taking the next steps and joining me. I get to speak all over the country, and I want to invite you on April 23rd, 24th, or 25th to the Ultimate Parent Conference. We've hosted these conferences all over California, and I speak in 25 out of 50 states in the United States. I've spoken to 25 states, and I go to schools all over the country. I want to give you this in the convenience of your home. You can watch live during one of my Parent Night events where I present, and you have Q&A, how to find out if your students have a fake Instagram account, how to turn off the location sharing, when your students should get a phone, how to get your student positive online. We're going to talk about a lot of positive online branding, how to search for your student. But let me show you more. This is what the registration page looks like. Smart Social Parent Conference, April 23rd, 24th, and 25th. Join National Social Media Safety Speaker Josh Oakes as he shares his positive plan for parents and educators that help your family. Now, it's a social media safety speech that brings you up to speed on the latest apps, the worst apps, the good apps. Here's what you're going to learn. When your kid should get a cell phone. Now, it's none of this vague stuff. I have a plan. The psychologists seem to say, wow, that was really great. When should my kids be on social media? We've got a detailed plan that shows you step by step. It's pretty awesome. How do colleges search for students and why? I'm going to show you how to do that way ahead of the game. How to find out if your kid has some hidden features in Instagram. How to find out if your kid has his hidden features in Snapchat. How to monitor your kids online. I got a ton of stuff for you. It's all tactical and practical. Now, that's what parents learn live, but I've also got on-demand student presentations. So that month, in the month of April, April 23rd, and plus a few weeks, you can sit down with your kids and watch micro segments of the student presentation I give. And it's, you know, for about $6,000 or $7,000, they fly me all over the country to give this amazing piece of content, and I want to share it with you. It's been tested on over 150,000 students, tips that'll motivate your student to want to be positive online without parental pressure. That's key. Next, how to be positive on Instagram and Snapchat, how colleges are going to search for students and applicants online, examples of good and bad results colleges are going to notice first, how to one adult lost a dream job with just one post on social media, and then why colleges want you to start building a personal brand in high school. It's a lot of stuff, and I motivate students to want to do it on their own. You don't have to tell them, hey, what you're doing is going to be online forever. They go, oh, mom, you're so uncool. I know you love me, but my job is to be the cool uncle and to make sure that we are taking the next step and you are protected. And they go, hey, that way you can say, you know, Josh suggested you probably don't want to do that because of this, this, and this. And they go, oh, yeah, you're right. You're no longer the bad person. Now, Tuesday, April 23rd, we're doing it at 6:30 p.m. Eastern time. And then if you miss that, you can join us 6:30 p.m. Pacific. So 3 hours later on the Eastern, it's 9:30 Eastern. If you're in the Midwest, pick whichever one you want. You can join us at any time. And then April 24th, same time. April 25th, same time. It's a 60 to 90 minute presentation. So sit down, enjoy it. Bring your spouse. You can bring your kids if you want to. It's really a parent night event, but bring whoever you want. Kids, and at the end of it, they say, you know what, this was interesting. He spoke to me like an adult. I kind of liked it. And it gives them hope and purpose. It's a little bit different than some of those competing documentaries out there that talk about screen time. We usually get a call after them and we go, hey, we've seen your content. We really want that plan, that purpose, and we want to be positive towards the students. I'm so glad you guys watched this. I'm so honored to be a part of your family. Please visit smartsocial.com. Take that next step. Join my parent conference. I want to protect your family. As a part, as a little added bonus, you're going to someday find out how. Very soon, I'm going to give a micro course in our updates section of our Smart Social community, our parent community. You're going to get the chance to learn how we use Dashlane, OnePass, and all these other pieces of software. You just pick one to protect your passwords so that you have less of a chance of getting hacked. You see, there's so many different apps out there. If you make a different password for each app, it's really good, but you'll go crazy if you can't remember them. So what we do is we use these pieces of software, which are free to $40 a year. I pay $40 a year, and I'm gonna show you how I build and use a password manager to make sure I don't get hacked. And I even set my parents up with one. They didn't understand why at first. And then I finally showed them and they go, I get it. And now they're more safe. I want the same for you. Join us at smartsocial.com for $15 a month or $99 a year. You're going to get access to my parent night events. I'm so honored to have you here. Thanks so much, guys. I'll see you soon.